One of the features that distinguishes one person from another is their height. At the same time, it may differ among representatives of a certain nationality or population. Also, the average height of people who have lived in a certain area for a long time is statistically approximately the same. In addition, such factors as heredity, the level of development of medicine, proper nutrition, and many others influence the length of a person's body. Today, we'll tell you what the height of our early ancestors was and how it changed during the process of evolution. Be sure to subscribe to the channel, and then you'll be the first to know when we post new videos about the history of development of life on Earth. Be sure to comment on the videos with your opinions and leave likes. Any engagement helps promote the channel and introduce it to as many people as possible. Supporters of conspiracy theories and various pseudo-scientific movements often tell us about a race of giants who lived on Earth long before people. In different versions, they could be Atlanteans and Lemurians and anyone else, but they all have in common a height of at least 2 meters. Statues, bas-reliefs on ancient temples and ancient buildings with high ceilings are cited as evidence, but neither archaeology nor anthropology has any reliable information about these ancestors of ours. Therefore, we cannot seriously consider the version of the origin of people from ancient giants. It's believed that the ancestors of people evolved from very small ape-like creatures. They led an arboreal lifestyle and ate exclusively plant food. But even before the complete transition to walking on the ground, they began to increase in size. For example, archosauruses, which lived more than 50 million years ago, had a body length of no more than 7 centimeters. And eosimia, which appeared 5 to 10 million years later, were the size of an adult's palm. Proconsul, who lived in the African jungle from 17 to 23 million years ago, already had a body length of 120 to 150 centimeters. And the Dryopithecus that lived in East Africa for about 12 million years didn't grow more than 60 centimeters. Australopithecus of different species had an average height of no more than 1.5 meters. They existed from 1 to 4 million years ago, and with a high degree of probability, it could be said that they gave rise to the genus Homo, of which we're a part of. While our ancestors lived in trees, their small height and light weight allowed them to climb to higher branches. This allowed them to both escape danger and expand their diet. Perhaps, when moving to the savannas that appeared in place of forests, it was easier for short primates to hide in the grass from land predators. But with a tall stature, it was possible to notice danger earlier. Therefore, the probability of survival of taller individuals increased significantly. The earliest primitive man known to science, Homo erectus, could grow up to 180 centimeters long. Erectuses appeared just under 2 million years ago and died out only about 300,000 years ago. During this time, they and their relatives expanded beyond the African continent. Some of them managed to reach Southeast Asia and populate some Pacific islands. Even before erectuses, we can mention Homo heidelbergensis. Their height could also exceed 180 centimeters, but much less is known about them compared to the Homo erectus. In addition, it's unlikely that this species was our immediate ancestor. It was probably easier for tall people to cover long distances during long migrations. They also had a better chance of fighting off or escaping predators. But we shouldn't forget that, in addition to this, Homo erectus learned to use fire, make various tools, and, possibly, sew primitive clothing. The lifestyle and living conditions of Homo erectus already began to affect growth when it spread across the planet. An example is the so-called Flores Man. These degenerate erectuses are often called hobbits, comparing them to the characters in Tolkien's novels. Their average height was slightly over 90 centimeters. The reason for this degeneration was the isolation of the population that settled on the island of Flores. The hobbits decreased not only in length, judging by their small skulls, their brain size was also small. But even now, there are several people on Earth that are distinguished by their extremely short stature. These are pygmies, bushmen, Andamanese, negrils, and the Ada. Moreover, these people originated before our ancestors left Africa. It's believed that they arose as a result of the assimilation of some other related species by the Cro-Magnons. These species of people developed in parallel and were our close relatives. In Europe and Asia, the same thing happened with the Neanderthals and Denisovans, but with a slightly different result. At the time of their exit from Africa, our immediate ancestors, the Cro-Magnons, aka Homo sapiens, faced serious competition. Neanderthals had already inhabited the territory of Europe 40,000 years ago, and they looked the complete opposite of sapiens. Neanderthals were squat and wide, had massive skulls and a powerful torso. The height of Neanderthals barely exceeded 1.5 meters. According to one version, such body proportions allowed Neanderthals to retain heat better. Homo sapiens could boast a height of up to 180 centimeters. Perhaps this difference also played a role in the confrontation between the two species of people. But we shouldn't forget that the Cro-Magnons were more numerous and better organized. They were able to make more complex tools, and most likely had a more developed speech. As a result, after 10,000 years, the Neanderthals either died out or were assimilated by the Cro-Magnons. Not much is known about the Denisovans yet, but we can say for sure that the Cro-Magnons, Neanderthals, and Denisovans were genetically very close and could have had common offspring. Over time, all the tribes were divided into nomadic and sedentary. Each type of civilization is distinguished by its achievements in different areas. But the change in lifestyle also affected the change in people's height. It's believed that the predominance of plant foods negatively affects the average body length of people, but at the same time, nomads were almost always significantly shorter than sedentary residents. Probably, such a difference in height was affected by the higher quality and variety of food. Also, city dwellers lived in relative comfort compared to nomadic people. But statistics still show that from ancient times to the beginning of the 19th century, the average height of people decreased. And only in the last 150 to 200 years, this trend has changed in the opposite direction. But at all times, the influence of climate and living conditions on people's height was very strong. For example, the body proportions of the inhabitants of Central Asia in the period between 20 and 28,000 years ago acquired features characteristic of Neanderthals. The average height of men was 165, and women, 155 centimeters. They were dense and stocky. This is how they were affected by living in a cold climate with very meager food resources. The influence of climate on the average height of people is clearly visible in the example of studying the inhabitants of Europe. In the 5 to 6 centuries AD, their average height was 172.3 centimeters. In the 11th century, a little more than 170 centimeters. And by the middle of the 19th century, the average height of European men was 167 centimeters. The early Middle Ages were the so-called climatic optimum. The climate on the entire planet was much warmer than it is now. This made it possible to obtain more harvests and grow various agricultural crops even in northern countries. A sharp decline in the average height of Europeans began in the 12th to 14th centuries. At this time, there was a serious cooling of the planetary climate. This means that the quality and diversity of nutrition for most of the population worsened. Also, around this time, the plague raged throughout the region. In 1914, the average height of men was 162 centimeters, and women 151 centimeters. Research conducted in 2014 showed that on average, men now grow to 171 centimeters, and women to 159 centimeters. This is primarily due to improved nutrition and the development of healthcare. These indicators also differ depending on the region of residence. In the 20th century, a trend towards increasing human height was observed in more developed countries. But genetics also plays a certain role in this process. Now, the tallest people are considered to be residents of the Netherlands. The average height of men in this country is 182.5 centimeters. Over 150 years, they've grown by about 20 centimeters. If we compare with even more ancient times, then it's worth noting Iranian men and South Korean women. The former grew by 20 centimeters, and the latter by 16. At almost all times and among all people, women were slightly shorter than men. As a rule, at birth, boys are slightly larger than girls. Until school age, they grow at approximately the same rate. Then, the growth rate of girls increases, and boys, on the contrary, decreases. Around 13 years old, their height becomes the same. But by the age of 18, boys are significantly ahead of girls in height. Now, on average, women on the planet are 12 centimeters shorter than men. But this difference varies greatly among different nations. In Macedonia, men are taller than women by an average of 18.5 centimeters, while in Gambia, they're only 4.5 centimeters taller. The tendency for the body length to increase was observed in the ancestors of modern humans in parallel with the development of the brain and the settlement of the planet. At all times, the growth of people were mainly influenced by living conditions and genetic predisposition. In the 20th and 21st centuries, this indicator is greatly influenced by the quality of medicine and nutrition, as well as the general standard of living of the state. We're grateful to everyone who watched the video all the way to the very end. If you want to learn more about human evolution, we recommend paying attention to the previous releases. They also talk about the origin of a variety of living creatures, the problems of human society, and, of course, dinosaurs.